Welcome back. In this class, we are going to discuss about an application-oriented alternate gate circuits or other forms of CMOS logic, that is differential cascade voltage swing logic. If you observe that the short form of DCVSL, it is abbreviated as differential cascade voltage swing logic. We will see the block diagram of it. Now this is the general block diagram of differential cascade voltage swing logic. If you observe that, it consists of two outputs. Now you can very clearly observe here, one is a complement output, another one is a regular output. Now you can observe that here, an important point here, if you are having one PMOS network here, then other side the complement of PMOS network should be present. That means here, if the transistors are in parallel, let us consider A and B are the inputs. Here the transistor should be in series and the input should be A complement and B complement. Is it clear? Now you can observe that, okay, the output here is acting as an input to this PMOS transistor and the output here is acting as an input to this PMOS transistor. Is it clear? Now you can observe that two similar type of circuits or side by side, therefore I can call it as a differential configuration, and the output of one is acting as an input, therefore I can call it as a cascade one, okay, and this circuit will produce full swing. Is it clear? Therefore the name is differential cascade voltage swing logic. I hope that are you clear. Now I am going to explain the same circuitry with a simple example, that is two input NAND gate. Okay, now I would like to design a two input NAND gate, but don't forget in this circuit two input NAND gate output and also two input AND gate output will also reflect. Is it clear? Now you can observe how this type of circuitry is going to be designed very carefully. You can please observe. Now you can observe the operation of two input NAND gate and also two input AND gate simultaneously. You can observe very carefully here. Okay, now when A is 0, B is 0, what is happening if you observe that when A is 0, B is 0, okay, these two transistors will turn on. Therefore, there is a path for VSS to reach either from B or either from A. And what is an output here? Absolutely, 0 is an output. And this 0 will pass to this transistor, then it will turn on and there is a path to VDD and the output here is 1. Further, there is no path here. I hope that are you clear. Now we can very clear that Y is 0, Y complement is 1. I hope that are you clear. Now similarly, when you talk about A is 0, B is 1. See here, if A is 0, B is 1, this will be turns off and this will be turns on, but still there is no path here. But here you can observe that B will be turns off but A is turns on, therefore you are having a path here to reach this VSS to this output. Once again, what is an output? 0 is an output. This 0 will pass here. And once again, what is an output? 1 is an output. Therefore, it is also verified. Now, the next combination you can talk about. What is the next combination? A is 1, B is 0. Okay, here if A is 1, this will be turns on and this will be turns off. Still, there is no path here. Is it clear? Now, you can observe that here, since B is 0 here, therefore, it will be turns on, it will be turns off. Therefore, there is a path here to move to this. What is an output? Still 0, and this 0 will pass to here and there is a path to VDD. And what is an output? 1 is an output. Is it clear? 0 and 1. And finally, if you talk about the last combination, what is that combination? 1-1 combination. You can observe very carefully. Since A is 1, B is 1, this will be turns off and this will be turns off. Further, there is no path here. Is it clear? But here, these two transistors will be turns on. Therefore, you are having a path here. Then this VSS will move to here. What is an output now? 0 is an output. You can observe this NAND gate 0. And this 0 will move here and this will be turns on. Then there is a path to VDD. Then what is an output? 1. Therefore, finally, I can conclude that, okay, at the complement side, you are having a complement output. That is what? NAND gate. Here, at the normal side, you are having a normal output, AND gate. In this manner, the differential cascade voltage swing logic will work. Not only for this NAND, if you want to design OR, you may get two outputs, NOR and OR. If you want to design XOR, then you may get two outputs, XOR and XNOR. This is the beauty of this circuit. Okay, if you are having any queries, please comment. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.